You must build out full projects in order to become a better developer. But where to start? Because there are hundreds of projects that you can build. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com and I want you to smash that subscribe button because today I'm going to show you the three types of projects that you need to build out in order to become a great programmer. Whenever you're planning to build out full projects so you can show off, for example, in your portfolio, there are a lot of options. And today we are going to take a look at how you should approach this. What types of apps do you need to build to become a programmer? Now, these are the builds that I highly recommend. And there's a system to this. I highly recommend that you take it one step at a time. But what to build? That is the question. Not build or not to build. You should definitely build. But what to build? This is the question. And there are these levels that I usually say to starter programmers. There's level 3, level 2, and level 1 type of projects. And we are going to cover all of the projects that might fit into these level 3s. And of course, why and how you should approach those. Take it one level at a time. This is my approach. You should just start at level 3 and build out some apps for you. And then you just move on to the next level. If you do want to learn how these levels work, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call and we can chat about these levels or Swift UI or Swift in general. Now, the first level is actually level 3, the beginner level. And the beginner projects are tend to do between 1 and 3 things, not many things, just maybe just one thing. And then you know how to do and build that one thing better. So it doesn't use any libraries or frameworks, and it's usually less than 300 lines of code. That is my kind of take on it. If it's more, then maybe it's a level 2 type of project, but that's kind of a guideline. And of course, it doesn't need a backend. Backend is a whole other thing. And yeah, these are just simple projects that you need to start upon. Build time, they are around 2 to 3 days per project. So that is what you should think about. And how many should you build on this? Well, my suggestion is around 7. It could be 5, 6, 7, 8, maybe even 10, who knows. But these are the numbers that I kind of found that, okay, then the fundamentals will be okay with these projects. Now, here are some examples for beginner projects. A digital clock, for example. You just display a clock, it's counting up over time. Also a countdown timer, so it's counting down. Maybe you create a stopwatch there. Rock, paper, scissors app. It's just doing one thing and it's really, really easy. It doesn't require a backend. A vowel counter for, let's say, a text. A calculator app. It does all of these calculations. And basically, these are kind of these small projects that you can build out in 2 to 3 days. Now, what is level 2? Level 2 are intermediate projects. That's about 4 to 10 things, not that much, but a little bit more than those 3 things or just one thing that beginner projects do. Does use some libraries or frameworks, for example, Core Data. Maybe you want to use that, or iCloud, or maybe some Firebase. It doesn't have to be, by the way, a backend. It could be, but it's not necessary. It's between 300 and 600 lines of code, usually. And to build out one of these apps, it usually takes between 1 and 2 weeks. It depends on the project, of course. And how many should we build? Well, around 4. Of course, the smaller ones, the beginner ones, are really easy to make and it doesn't take that much time. But just around 4 is fair enough here for these intermediate projects. And yeah, you could just build out your portfolio with these. And you do want to have a little bit more of these beginners and then a little bit less from the intermediates and a few expert ones. So around 4 is the quite a number, good number for these level 2s. And what are these projects that you want to build? So expense tracker, that's a really good one because then you have to use, let's say, Core Data and of course some UI, but still it doesn't do that much. You don't have to have authentication or all of that stuff. Notes, recipes app, weight tracker, a to-do list app, a Wordle clone maybe. Wordle is really, really popular today. So yeah, maybe you just want to build out a Wordle clone. So that's level two. Level one is the next one. And what do we want to have here? Well, it has to do more than 10 things, around more than 10 things. It has to have an authentication. So registering, signing up, it has to have a profile, editing the profile, maybe having some, let's say, if it's, let's say, Instagram, then you want to post an image, you want to filter that image, you want to fetch an image, you want to follow, you want to like. So there are more than 10 things that these apps want to do. Does use libraries or frameworks at this point? You're not just going for the basics. You want to learn how to use complex libraries, maybe APIs. And it's usually more than 600 lines of code and does have a backend. It doesn't, usually it does have a backend because that's more complex. This is, these are more complex projects and backends do make the project more complex. And the build time for these are around 1 or 2 months per project. So yeah, as you can see, there are many, many features here. Now, before we dive into letting you know what type of projects you might use, let's pick a winner from previous videos comments. And if you do want to have a free mentoring session with me, just go ahead and like this video, share it, and comment down below, and I will pick you, maybe you, as the next winner for a free 60-minute Zoom call with me. And today we are going to pick a winner for our previous video. Let's just paste it right over here. Let's fetch our comments right over there. There we go. Let's pick a winner. And there we go. David is our winner. Now, David, if you're watching this, contact me at support@rebeloper.com with the email address that you have posted this comment, and you get a free 60-minute Zoom coaching call with me. Now, let's get back to our slides. And how many should I build? How many apps, these more complex, should we build? Well, around two. It could be one, but yeah, that's just one. And you can just show it off in your portfolio. But around two, like two, three, maybe even four of these projects is kind of ideal. Just make sure that they are really polished and they do work as expected. Now, here are some examples of the complex projects in level one. An Instagram clone. So yeah, as I told you, it has authentication, sign up, registering, profiles, editing profiles, posts, fetching the posts inside the feed, following users, liking, maybe adding some comments. So there are a lot of complexities inside the app. And as you most probably know, in the other ones that I list out here, they do have at least 10 or more functionalities. The Twitter clone, iMessage clone, like a chat application, TikTok clone, where you can record your videos and then post them and fetch them. Uber clone, where you can have a dive into maps and location services. So yeah, do try to do at least two of these projects, and then you have your portfolio kind of full. Now, building projects is not enough, because that is just one facet of learning how to code. And why do 95% of self-taught developers fail? Well, you can find out on this video that I made. Do this or keep struggling.